Hi, I sound like shit because I have COVID. Don't worry, I am vaccinated and have taken enough cold medicine to sedate a horse. But the good news is that I don't have to go to work, which means I have abundant free time to make videos for y'all. Overcome the fever, am I right? Let's talk about the new AT's comeback. I'm very excited for it. Based on the promotional content we have so far, I do think there's a good chance I'm going to be wrong about a lot of my color theory predictions. Which is chill, it's fine. This is just for fun, okay? I'm going to be wrong about things. But I've also felt this way before, like when these album covers came out, I was like, what the hell is Orange doing there? When Thanks was released, I legitimately thought for several days that KQ was completely not doing color theory stuff anymore because that is how much Thanks makes absolutely no fucking sense to me. This promotional poster was released and then Fever 2 ended up being a very red album. Basically what I'm saying is I'm still holding out a little hope for Yellow and Green just because I feel like we have a year and a half of evidence, but I'm also not really expecting it to happen for this comeback. So on that note, what fucking color is this? I've spent so much time looking at it, I think it's orange, I really do. Everyone on Twitter is calling it orange. But it could also be red, and I want it to be red because red would make a lot more sense to me. But it's very different from this shade of red that they used in all their other promotional stuff, so I don't know. Cast your vote in the comments. Is this red or is it orange? I think the fact that the diary version is yellow means we're probably gonna get some diary entries that talk about the yellow smoke. Like, actually part of the reason the Fever 3 diary version is orange is because they mention the color orange in that set of diary entries. Anyways, mostly I want to talk about the title. The World EP1 Movement. There are so many things going on with this title. First, double meanings. I'll probably make a separate video at some point about all the AT's lyrics and words and phrases that have double meaning because there's a lot of them, but both parts of this title have double meaning. Movement can refer to moving your body, or it can refer to social action, to rebellion, starting a movement. Which is just super clever because Holotease's movement, their dancing, is also their act of rebellion, the art they make that is illegal in Strictland. The world can refer to the world, planet Earth, and the population of people who live on it, the people ATs are trying to reach with their music, but the world is also a very overt reference to their storyline, the crossing over between the new world and the old world. You can see the same double meaning being utilized in their Wake Up World teaser. Wake Up World as in, hey, everybody around the world, pay attention to us, we're going to have a comeback, and Wake Up World, given that in their storyline they have to be asleep in one dimension in order to be awake in the other, ATs always wakes up in the world opposite to the one they fell asleep in. In fact, almost every single word in this entire teaser has double meaning, and it's very impressive, but again, that's another video. The world is also a reference to ATINI, since we are ATs' whole world, right? We are very special and important to them. ATINI are the people all around the world that ATs makes their music for. And just like Treasure, this goes the other way too. ATs is our world. So, like all their other releases, the world will likely be a series about light, about treasure, about the connection between ATs and their fans. And you can see this already in things like the light stick design, where the bulb is literally a globe, and also in Deja Vu, where the world is one of the sets of constellations. The world is also a reference to the Chromer, since the Chromer contains the two worlds within it, up and down, old and new. The Chromer is what allows you to change the world, which is a lyric from all the way back in Intro Long Journey. And there's a lot of other AT's lyrics about the world that I'm sure will all tie into this series in interesting ways. I also think maps are probably going to be important in this series, given that a map is just a picture of the world. So I'm hoping for a more detailed version of the map from Illusion at some point. I think maps also make a lot of sense for the progression of their journey. If Treasure is the very beginning, where they choose to embark on this journey, and then Fever is their official takeoff and the storm they face on the way to Utopia, then that would make this next series focused on them navigating the sky or landing on Utopia and beginning to navigate the island. In either case, they're gonna need a map. Also, if this comeback is the beginning of the world, then that means in the future of this series, we're going to get an album that is about the end of the world. Which I think is going to be really cool and goes along with all the utopia, dystopia stuff and everything we see take place in Fireworks with the burning of the new world. And oh my god, I'm so excited. I also quite like the idea of end of the world events like massive fires and volcanoes that then create rich soil for plants and trees. I know, I'm obsessed with plants, I'm sorry. But just the concept that death creates life, the end leading to the beginning. I can also definitely see Robert Frost's Fire and Ice poem tying into this too, since it's a poem about how the world will end and talks about fire being a metaphor for human desire. Plus, it's in a Twilight movie, so jot that down somewhere. And also the whole idea of opposites, fire and ice, hot and cold, day and night, awake and asleep, up and down, old and new, Oreo hair. See, it's great, because now you can just show someone your Hong Jun photo card and they'll be like, what is this? And you can say, this is an incredibly concise yet thorough explanation of the core meaning of all AT's content, which centers around two opposites that coexist within one thing. And then that person will probably never speak to you again, but it's fine. As for my thoughts on the concept photos, no thoughts, head empty, boys pretty, what in the buff cinnamon roll? Green, maybe? Anyways, thanks for watching.